American business magazine Forbes recently released an online article naming the Philippines the 10th fastest growing economy in the world, despite controversy over President Rodrigo Duterte. According to the article, the Philippines' economy is expected to advance between 6.5 to 7.5% for 2017, almost twice the country's long-term growth. While this is good news for the Philippines, critics of the president like Ago Petalizo of the Philamps for Human Rights Alliance, or FARA, says the Philippines' economy was already steadily growing before Duterte.
The growth that you've seen with Duterte is still a spillover effect of the rapid growth that you've seen under the Aquino regime. I mean, from 2010 to 2016, you had an average of 6.2.
Meanwhile, Kelly Dayag of the Dig on Duterte Supporters Northern California chapter says the growth will continue under Duterte thanks to his 10-point socioeconomic agenda.
We get credit where credit is due. Partly of that, of course, from the policies set in place by the Aquino government, is just being polished and being improved by the Duterte administration.
Petalizo argues that the behavior of the president, his war on drugs, and his declaration of martial law in Mindanao are actually hurting the country's economy.
The competitiveness ranking that we've earned back in 2013, where we ranked from 59 to 33 in terms of competitiveness, we're losing it. We have the Marawi incidents, you have killings of 12,000, the oligarchs are gathering again.
However, Dayag says that the president is only doing what's best to keep the country safe, while also working with foreign investors to help alleviate the debt, which, according to the Freedom from Debt Coalition, is a debt of $6.4 trillion that Duterte inherited from Aquino.
Every administration, there is debt, there is, you know, but it will be offshoot, it can be offshooted, offshoot can be done by the investors, by the spending, especially once the tax reform will be laid in place. Who knows, 20 years, 10 years from now, we will be like Singapore.
What's happening under Duterte is just a repetition of Marcos. They keep getting money from abroad. People are living under dictatorship. And at some point in time, the economy will just go down.
As Duterte's one-year anniversary in office approaches, these Kababayans say that while they disagree, they hope the president will make better decisions to improve the country. Ramel Quinclara, ABS-CBN News.